I gotta see this again. I know you're gonna shoot me and everything, but here's the thing, my friend. That's not how you ride that raft, okay? You're supposed to keep it on water. That's not... Okay, you're mad you're shooting me. I understand that, but... Look, that's just not how it's supposed to work, okay? Just throwing it out there for you. What is going on, everybody? Welcome to Landless. I'm your host, the Birdman, known as Falcon. And this right here is kind of what I wanted Raft to eventually be like. You guys remember Raft? We covered like maybe a video or two of it a while back. It was really big for a while. It's a free game on itch, but I felt like development just kind of halted for it altogether. And here we have Landless kind of picking up that slack. However, it's still an early alpha game as well, but it has a bit more features than a Raft. Essentially here, you are in an open world, post-apocalyptic water world. It doesn't have Kevin Costner, though, in case you're wondering, but it's you and your boat, and basically, I think there's no more land. Small little civilizations out there in the ocean, so it's a survival game. You have to manage your hunger, you build stuff and stuff like that, pirates, all sorts of jazz. It's very early in development, and I'm not too familiar with it just yet, so let's get into the game over here and just show you a little bit of the game, and it's something I would say keep in your radar. I'm not sure if you want to go balls to the wall in just yet, but at least keep on your radar, especially if you're a big post-apocalyptic, you know, survivor game fan like I am. But it's early in development, so you might want to just kind of keep your eyes on it and see what happens here. So here we go. Okay. What? Stop. Is that because I have my controller plugged in? No? You're just crazy. Can we please stop? Stop it. Stop it. What's the deal here? Hey, well, you know, that's Landless, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. All the information... I'll fix this. Hold up. Are we good now? Oh, we're good now. Okay. Oh, those early access alpha games, huh? So here we have Professor Goodman. Transmission begins.
Hey, kid. Wake up. That was one hell of a storm. Can't believe you made it out. Press left down to toggle the mouse cursor. Click on flashing icons to learn more about the world around you.
So, let's see here, left out.
I've got our encryption software running now. Hopefully I'll be with you every step of the way to the Ecotech headquarters. Go to the front of the boat and press F to start the boat.
I'm not gonna do that just yet, okay? Because I wanna, like, you know, learn a bit what's happening here. So as you can see, the water effect's pretty good. You know, it's very repetitive, but it looks pretty nice, I will admit that. It's a decent looking game, nothing that's gonna, you know, blow your mind away, but it's alright. So over here with left out, you get to inspect things as we see here. So we found a box, we have cooked potatoes and a bottle of water. We will take everything in there right now. And these will be my fuel canisters, and these will be for water collection, which we have to then purify in order to drink. Because you can't just, you know, pour, you know, bop your head over the side of the boat and just drink, you know? That's very terrible. You'll probably wind up really terrible off in the ocean if you ever do that. We can also go into the water. You don't want to do it right now or what? Huh? Okay, I'm trying to teach the people some things here, okay? Please, work with me. So you can go into the water whenever you deal with pirates. You could actually get out there and grab their loot after you kill them. And, you know, get back in and stuff like that. So that's cool. Over here we have... I think a way for us to cook, if I'm right. We have our engine over here, and this will be our wench. Okay, so everything's good over here, right? Everything's fine. You want me to interact with that. And this will be our crafting bench right here. And I guess we'll cover more of that here pretty soon. But that's all the basics for now. Let's get into the boat here. Alright, technically we're on the boat. We're on a boat!
Whoa, kid, that doesn't sound good. Looks like you're gonna have to rebuild the engine. Hey, kid, now's the time to be lazy. Go use the material I stash in your inventory. Go to the workbench on the left and press F to interact with it. Make sure you disembark from your boat by pressing F again.
Oh, I'll F you, my friend. How about that? No, you're a fine fellow, Professor Goodman. Okay, so... let's come over here to my workbench.
You can press I to open and close your inventory. I made sure you'd have spare parts with you. Go ahead and craft basic engine. Now wait until you're finished crafting it.
Alrighty. And you have to build stuff here, and then when you build stuff, you have to wait for it to get done, which sometimes can be annoying, but the game does actually speed it up after a while, so that's actually pretty cool. So, let's see here. We need to make the engine, right? So let's go over to crafting. And let's look for this engine, which is right over here. There's a lot of stuff to build, as you can see over here. You guys could pause and read everything there is to build at your heart's content. There's a lot of, like, parts for the ship. We could definitely upgrade the ship pretty baller. You could also make your own little water world village as well. You could build walls, you know, buoys, you know, roofs, all that stuff. So you could definitely have a little small house in the ocean, which is very, very cool as well. And there's a lot of stuff, as you can see. But what we're looking for right now is going to be the basic engine, which requires everything that we have. Luckily, thanks to our boy, Mr. Goodman. So let's craft this item right here. And I believe it's also going to require a significant amount of whale oil to build some stuff. For this one, we need 5. So I believe that'll give us down to 995, assuming my basic mathematics are working properly here today. Hey, they are. Look at that. Falcon knows how to subtract 5 numbers. Oh, boy.
Now we are going to equip the basic engine, so go ahead and close the crafting window. So left-click to drag the basic engine to your inventory and put it on the engine. There should be 2 slots, but keep in mind you can only have 1 engine or main component equipped at any time. I'm using the Waster sonar network. We're going to pinpoint a nearby settlement for you. Uploading coordinates to your GPS now.
Thank you. Why does he sound that way, you're asking me? Well, you know, he's had a hard life, you know, living out in the ocean for one, and, you know, he's a hardcore smoker as well, so that's what I'm going with here. Oh, right, let's get out of here, and now we want to equip this right over to our engine. So now we're good to go, as you can see. Excellent over here, and our buoyancy also dropped a bit, because now we are more weighty because of the engine. So that's pretty cool.
Head there to Leavenworth to get started on your journey. I'm monitoring the boat, so I'll contact you again when you reach there. I need to get back to the captain. It's absolute mayhem over here after your escape. No doubt the captain will suspect I had a hand in it. Don't worry about me, kid. Just get to that town and stay alive.
And that'll be it. Okay, so apparently we escaped from somewhere. I'm not too familiar with the story of the game. I haven't played this game too much as yet, but just the basics. So I think we're good to go here. We might want to also possibly equip ourselves a weapon because there's going to be a lot of pirates out here, so we'll need that. How's our hunger? Hunger and thirst is fine. Sleep is going to be fine. Sleep, you will need that, obviously, to get some rest, but it'll also be a way for you to save the game. However, keep in mind that at the same time, whenever you rest, you also use up, you drop in terms of thirst and hunger, so you got to have to mediate when you want to save. You can't be saving nonstop, otherwise you run out of food and resources pretty fast. So I think we're good to go here. Let's now hit the road. I think we're going up there, so there we go. All right. And I love the fact you can do the whole 360 spin over here. You should be able to put this motherfucker on autopilot and just kind of roam around and be like, yeah, I'm a captain of my own little ship over here. I'm not sure why I'm sounding like Professor Goodman now, too. Apparently, my character's also been a hardcore smoker his entire life.
No one knows where Ecotech is located. Some even say that it's actually a giant container ship constantly roaming the ocean. But the best way to get closer to them is through the tech. Ecotech has research beacons across the world. These beacons are constantly collecting data. You need to destroy the beacon to get it to eject its black box. These black boxes will help you trace them back to the original source. Watch out, I'm picking up waster activity headed your way to Leavenworth. I'll try to contact you again when you reach the research beacon.
Alright, so this should be fine. Let's get off of here. Let's bring my gun out if we can. Let's keep an eye out here really quickly. Where are you at, scumbags, huh? Wasters and salters. You're fine right now? Okay, let's jump.
Jump, let it all out. These are the things I can do without, come on.
Okay, I'll stop singing. So let's see what we have here. This will be a little small water village. As I mentioned, it's just like the whole rafting I told you guys about. Like in Raft, you could do this, build whatever you want to build. But after a while, you kind of like, you know, excuse me. Okay. Apparently you can't just walk over, they gotta jump up. But after a while with rafting, you build, and that's about it. You can deal with the shark occasionally too. Here, it's a bit more evolved, so I'm really digging this thus far. We took some damage. Okay, hold up. Ah, there they are. Stop. Okay, buddy. You wanna tangle? Huh? You wanna tangle, motherfucker? Oh, you're escaping, huh? No, you're not escaping. You're not going anywhere, my friend. Oh, my friend's dead. I better leave now. No. I don't think that's going to work out. Body's just over there floating about. I love that. But we should be able to get some loot off of them. Here we go. That's what I was looking for. Scrap wood, scrap metal, and some biofuel, which we obviously need for our ship, so that's always a good thing to have. Okay. Now, what do we have here? I'll be honest with you, this is as far as I played. I don't know what to do here in this village at this point now. So now I'm at a loss, but I guess we'll figure it out. It's not rocket science after all, right? Yeah, I feel like there's just not enough indication whenever, like, dudes show up. They're on the map, maybe, on the mini-map? Maybe I should pay more attention to that, I'm not sure. Well, over here we possibly have a store. So... And the enemies continuously spawn, from my experience, so... It's another bit of a hindrance over here after a while. You want to check out the city or the town over here, and then the enemies just constantly show up over and over and over. Although it's a good way to kind of, like, you know, gather up resources early on. And this happened last time when I played the game, too. This merchant apparently is just walking up against that wall. Therefore, I really can't do much with him. Although I could turn on a little flashlight right there. Looks nice and good. And apparently, I could also rob him blind. So I will take everything over here if I can. You don't mind, do you? Nah, you're too busy right now just walking up against that wall right there. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Well, what do you see over there, huh? What do you see over there? It must be very, very exciting for you to just continuously walk up against that wall, huh? Alrighty. Any other... Salters, wasters around? No, not yet. They usually wait to hit the ground. I would love to just hang out over here and snipe them if I could, but... They wait until you're on the ground floor. So here we have shotgun shells. Excellent. Take everything. Now, our inventory is limited, as you can see, so I have to kind of go back and drop some stuff off after a while. I was hoping we could pick up a shotgun from one of the wasters, but... Not just yet. Oh, up, 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 stop it, stop it, stop it. Now, what do we have here? Pop you open. Yeah, see, this is what I mean. Like, the NPCs are just completely... Glitched out, maybe? You stop walking, that's good. That's a good sign, but you don't talk to me. So there's no dialogue with them right now. When I was playing this off-camera for myself for a little while, I started building out here. And what I honestly did is I decided to take one of these little... This one right here. I decided to take this over for myself. And I started building stuff in there. And I figured this would be kind of like my little safe world where I'd go out into the ocean. I'd come back here whenever I had to drop some stuff off. So you can do that. I'm going to show you some of the crafting here pretty soon. But I decided to make this my fort. Because apparently nobody was in here. And if somebody was in here, I'd just probably blast them, so it's fine. Let's see if there's anybody here now. No? Yeah, see, this is like a really nice little... Outstanding little fort for myself here. So, for scrap wood. Take everything over here as well. Okay. My guy's over there stuck, too. Apparently another store owner. So, they send you over here to buy stuff, but apparently if the NPCs are kind of like glitched out, I'm not sure how you actually ever buy stuff. Then again, you can find so many goods, it's kind of like, do you really have to buy things over here? Oh, Cthulhu, how about that? How about that? Rifle ammo. So let's take everything over here. We cannot take Cthulhu nor rifle ammo. We are completely packed to the brim. So we'll have to come back. But as I mentioned, this is going to be my little fort. So right now, I'm going to actually go in here and maybe craft ourselves a bit of a storage bin. Now let's come over here and see about getting some food and water. Although I do have... Yeah, let's get some water here. Get some food. How much water do we need? A significant amount, I would say. And that'll be it. You do recover your HP by eating, so there is that. So it's not too hard to kind of keep yourself fully loaded with HP after these guys do a number on you. Now, I would like to get in here for a bit and see about crafting something for us before we wrap it up. Okay, excuse me. Get your ass in the boat here. Let's see. Interact. Okay, so crafting. What would I need to make a storage? Just because I want to, like, you know, have an extra bit of storage here. So for the storage, I do need... not there. Storage chest, here we go. So for you, we need wooden planks and 20 brackets, which I believe you make from this. But we're also out of space here. Okay, so we have our wooden planks now, and now we need 20 brackets, which I'm building from the scrap metal we have collected here thus far. That requires 2 scrap metal per bracket. Now this is what I wanted to show off here before we actually go out there and place this. Like, after a while, you see how we started with one, it was very slowly building up. Second one... But then the further the number you have, it starts speeding up until it actually goes really fast. So I'm not really sure what dictates this or why it happens, but it's very nice whenever you have to build like a ton of shit. So there it is. Now that's done. Let's go down here to storage chest, and we have enough to make that. Not 20. No. Just one is going to be enough for us. Now considering we've been out here a while, I would not be surprised if we have pirates just kind of waiting for us outside. That's okay. They could wait. Luckily for me, these pirates are very polite. They wait till you're done inside of your business, and then they start to kill you afterwards. Very honorable pirates, at the very least. So there we go. We have our chest right here. And as I mentioned, the way I played is I like to take one of these places over and just place my stuff in there. So let's see. Pirates? Pirates, are you here? Oh, you're surprisingly enough, you're not here. Weird. Okay. Well, let me come over here and just place down this item, and then we will go over to that buoy over there. Or wherever my map is telling me to— Oh, Jesus, they were right there the entire time! Oh. Oh, you're literally— they're literally on the land. Hold up, let me, this is so stupid. Let me actually have some food here. I gotta see this again. I know you're gonna shoot me and everything, but here's the thing, my friend. That's not how you ride that raft, okay? You're supposed to keep it on water. That's not— okay, you're mad you're shooting me, I understand that, but look, that's just not how it's supposed to work, okay? Just throwing it out there for you. Now, here's what I'm thinking. What happens when we kill— ow. Did you say ow? Yeah, look at that! So when we kill the aggro guy, this dude is in charge of actually controlling the raft. So after you kill him, he's supposed to book it. And he's not. Because he can't, because he's literally on top of this. Huh. The raft has a hole itself, does it? I wonder if we could, like, steal this or something. I'm kind of curious about this now. Let's get some water in us. We're kind of thirsty here. Can I steal this? Oh, I could do damage to the hole itself. Oh, really? I'm kind of curious about what happens now if we destroy the raft. Let me move away. Knowing this game, I would not be surprised if it just decided to, like, blow up or something. Just because, why not? Okay, how we doing now? Almost there, right? Well, I guess technically what we're doing is we're shooting the engine. Oh, good God, that's great. That's awesome. Are you gonna stay here the entire time now or what? Oh, barrels galore. Ooh, what are you gonna give me for that? Oops, sorry. There you go. Gun, please go away. Alrighty, so with all that said and done, let's come up here now and just set down my little chest to show you how that works out. And then we'll go check out that buoy, and then war that, I guess, is it a buoy? I'm not sure. It's a map point on my map, so I'm not sure what's over there, but I guess we might as well take a look at it. And then we'll wrap it up here. I just wanted to give you guys an idea as to what raft Landless is all about here. So for this, we just have to... Alright, the gun's still out. How do I, yeah, there we go. Put that away for good. And then, there is now my own personal box for my own belongings down the line, which is pretty cool. As I mentioned, I guess you could just take over anything you want here for now. There's no reason why you shouldn't. You could build something for yourself, but hey. Ah, nice. Sun's coming up and everything now. Pretty cool. And I guess that right there is our pinpoint at. And head over to that little location on our map and see what happens. At this point, we'll start wrapping it up here pretty soon, guys. So I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a look at what Landless is all about. I think there's promise in this game, but right now, as you saw, there's a bunch of weird shenanigans. NPCs kind of getting stuck over there. The non-stop, endless amount of those wasters that keep showing up over and over. I wish it was more of an indication whenever they actually show up as well, because otherwise you're over here busy doing some stuff. Suddenly you start losing health and you're wondering, like, well, what's happening? And then you're like, gotta play hide and seek with them and figure out where they're at. Oh, the music's back. Okay. Transmission begins. All right, kid, take a good look. That's an Ecotech MK5 research beacon. My top student before the Great Flood designed a mechanism using electric water displacement and an early anti-gravity prototyping to keep it completely buoyant with the surface of the water, yet be immovable as if it anchored down. He named it the Anchorless Technology. It's basically an immovable ocean surface satellite, but I digress. These things are incredibly tough. I advise you to conserve your bullets and focus on pulling it apart with a crowbar or hack it with an axe. I know it's going to take longer, but if you try to pry that thing open, it's gonna send a distress signal and... Oh boy, you're gonna need every last bullet of each damn salted waster and eco-drone that's heading your way. Destroy the beacon to stop the signal and collect the black box. Okay, cool. Thank you. Yeah. Okay, so... Use the crowbar. Or the axe, huh? Oh, there is a ladder after all. That's fine. Let's bring out crowbar or the axe. You do like roughly 35. Kind of the same thing, huh? I'm surprised you can actually see some structural damage, although it's very minimal. And it seems to just be floating, not on the actual texture itself, just kind of floating about. That's fine, you know, hey. It's effort. There's an A for effort here at the very least.
I'm compiling a database of blueprints and guides to send over to you to get all the essentials covered. I'm also sending a final version of my world image regenerative encryptor, or at least I like to call it the Wire. Wire takes all the data collected from those black boxes and... Yeah, okay.
Uploading. Thanks a lot, dude. Okay. You talk too much for one. Now suddenly we have Captain Wastebeard.
I should have known. The self-righteous, self-important professor. You selfish cur. I executed 10 of my loyal officers because of your handiwork.
Oh, it's a captain that we escaped from. Ah, so the professor's about to get dealt with too, huh? Pistol whip noise. Oh, that's no good.
And as for you, I gave you everything. Food, water, comfort, and security and knowledge. You will be mine. Kid, my job's done.
Oh no, Professor. Well, Professor's gonna probably die, but yeah, he got a gunshot finally. But he sent me the leftovers of what he wants me to do, which is to bring us back to land. And I'm sinking. Oh boy, am I sinking, alright. Let's get out of here. Jesus. But you guys have it, it is Landless. Pretty cool, it's a survival game, and there's also apparently a small little story to it as well, which could be pretty cool. I will have the information for this down below if you want to check it out for yourself. As I mentioned, maybe it's a bit rough around the edges right now, so just keep your eyes open, but I do like the premise of an open world, open water, survival, post-apocalyptic game. I will catch you next time.